No, give me that Exodus. Pants were always made for men. Now, what your slave master did was make you think there's such thing as women pants. There is no such thing. That man is a deceiver, and he deceived you, he lied to you, and make you think there's such thing as women's pants. There we go. When the truth come out, they start running.
Kill each other because they don't see each other in Jesus Christ.
Yeah, Israelite from the time of Jews. Let's look at Hebrews 7-14. Because they don't see each other in Jesus Christ. Let's look at
Come on, brother. What's the question? Come on up here. We are here for our people. You come right here. What's your name, bro?
Dimitrik.
I'm Jacob, man. We are here teaching our people who we are according to the scriptures.
I know. I watch you all the time.
Oh, okay.
This is my first time seeing you on the corners of Charleston. So I've just been looking.
Okay.
Trying to get down with it.
Okay.
I understand.
Yes, sir.
I got one question.
Yes, sir.
What's the difference between the Old Testament and the New Testament? People keep saying change. What changed? What did Jesus change about the Old Testament?
I'm going to tell you what changed. Hebrews 10. What changed was, you know, we used to sacrifice animals, right?
Right.
For our sins. Now we don't sacrifice animals no more because Christ came and been that sacrificial lamb for us, so we don't sacrifice animals no more. Now, as far as the food, right? So, give me that in Leviticus 11, because do you eat pork?
No, I stopped eating pork.
Stop eating pork, shrimp, crab, lobster, and all that.
I just stopped eating crab and shrimp.
Because guess what? Guess what? Give me Isaiah 66:15. Guess what? Because Leviticus 11, you can read all the abominations, right?
Right.
So you know what some of the abominations are, right?
Right.
That whole Leviticus 11. But now see, because some of our people are here, Leviticus 11, and not eating swine. And some of them say, you know what? I still don't care. I've had people actually say, you know what? I still don't care. Their life worth, that pork worth their life. No, so for some people, that's what it is, because they want to be stiff-necked and rebellious as hell. But we going to listen with God here. Watch this, Isaiah 66.
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 66 and verse 15.
Bring it out.
For behold, the Lord will come with fire and with his chariots like a whirlwind.
Second coming.
To render his anger with fury and his rebuke with flames of fire.
Christ is coming back with flames of fire. That's what he's coming back when he come back. He's coming to destroy this earth with fire. Read.
For by fire and by his sword will the Lord plead with all flesh, and the slain of the Lord shall be many.
So God said the slain of the Lord shall be many. We are here to try to tell our people to repent so you don't be a part of that. Because it said the slain of the Lord shall be many, many of his own people.
Right.
Read, let's see why. They that sanctify themselves, they separate themselves with what?
And purify themselves in the gardens behind one tree, in the midst of eating swine's flesh.
Eating what?
Swine's flesh.
You're going to have Christ coming back, and you're still going to have Negroes trying to, I'm going to eat this last unicorn. That's what God said. What's going to be for them? What does the scripture say? It said, flame from fire. The slain of the Lord shall be many. So guess what? You're going to have people in that day eating pork, God said he gonna kill. Just for eating the wrong stuff. Read.
And the abomination.
And all the abominations in the Leviticus 11 chapter. So if you found eating those things when Christ come back or still in the midst of eating those things, it's off with your head. The swine or any of the abominations when Christ come back, that's why all those unclean foods, we gotta get do away with those things.
Yeah.
Read, because you don't wanna be slain for just eating the wrong stuff. Watch it.
And the mouse shall be consumed together, saith the Lord.
I said they gonna be consumed in that fire. And guess what? There's a lot of our, cause I know down here, our people like the shrimp, crab, and lobster, and pork, and so forth. But guess what? If they don't repent of that thing, they gonna be slain, thus saith the Lord. But give me that Hebrews 8:8. Hebrews 8:8 and Jeremiah 31:31. There's, you know, the Old Testament, New Testament, basically saying the same thing.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
What's this? I hear some questions about, oh, that's the Old Testament.
No,
that's
what's
back.
Different?
God, Jesus didn't came back and changed that way. Then he came back. I see you.
What's this? Old Testament, New Testament. Because guess what? When Christ walked the earth, where was he teaching from? Was there a New Testament on the earth when Christ came?
No.
So where was he teaching from?
Israel.
What was he teaching from? Where he was teaching from? What was he teaching from? What books? The Old Testament, because there wasn't no New Testament. Yeah. Right. So the Christians, they damn foolish. We read that earlier.
Yeah, said,
our people foolish and wild to do evil.
I present to everything about he, when he came back, he died for the Old Testament. The Old Testament.
No.
But I know that
was
wrong.
No, we gonna get that too. You got it? Matthew, Jeremiah 31:31, Hebrews 8:8.
This is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 31:31.
Read it out.
Behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel.
He's gonna make the new covenant with
the house of Israel.
House of Israel, the 12 tribes. He ain't making a covenant with all people. Read.
And with the house of Judah. Not according to the covenant that I made with their fathers in the day that I took them by the hand to bring them out of the land of Egypt, which my covenant they break.
We broke that. We broke the covenant he made with our forefathers. We broke the covenant. We didn't want to keep nothing, he said. We broke them. Read.
Although I was an husbandman, an husband unto them, saith the Lord, but it shall be the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel. After those days, saith the Lord, I will put my law in their inward parts and write it in their hearts.
And in that day, he's going to put his laws within us, in our minds, in our hearts. Read.
And will be their God, and they shall be my people.
That's what God said. We're going to be his people, not all people. So that thing that Christ came for everybody, that's a damn lie that's been taught by the Christian church.
Right.
He ain't teaching no truth according to the Bible. That's it. Give me Hebrews 8:8. Guess what? The Old and New Testament saying the same thing. Watch this.
This is the book of Hebrews, chapter 8:8.
Real.
For finding fault with them.
Finding fault with the Israelites, read.
He saith, behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that I will make a new covenant.
So when we just read about that covenant there, in Jeremiah, right?
Jeremiah.
And it's the New Testament, in Hebrews, read.
I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and with the house of Judah. Not according to the covenant that I made with their fathers in the day when I took them by the hand to lead them out of the land of Egypt.
God is talking about covenants he gonna make with the house of Israel, not with all people. So he made a covenant in the Old Testament, and now he's making a new covenant in the New Testament. But who's the covenant for? You see what I'm saying? Us.
African-American, Latin, Mexican.
So-called.
Yeah.
Right. Watch this.
My bad.
Because they continued not in my covenant, and I regarded them not, saith the Lord. For this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, saith the Lord. I will put my laws into their mind and write them in their hearts, and I will be to them a God, and they shall be to me a people.
So he's going to put his laws within us, and we're going to be his people. He's going to be our God. You understand? So I'm going to ask you something. What'd you say your name was again?
Dimitri.
So you love God, right?
Oh, yes.
Love God.
Most high, yes.
How do you prove you love him?
I try my best.
Watch this. First, okay, all repentance. That's repentance. That's repentance.
Yes. I start learning more. I start trying to do the different things that I see on YouTube, like listening and reading it.
Okay.
Checking things out.
We're going to show you something real quick. Watch this. First John 5.
This is the book of 1 John, chapter 5:3.
Bring it out.
For this is the love of God, that we keep his commandments.
So the love of God is that we keep his commandments, right? Do you agree with that, right?
I agree with that.
All right.
And his commandments are not grievous.
Meaning his commandments are not hard. His commandments ain't hard. That's it. If you love God, what you gonna do? Keep his commandments. But we're going to bring something out right now. David, what's this?
This is the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 10:3.
Read out.
11:3. But I would have you know that the head of every man is Christ.
So the head of every man is who? Christ, right? So above you is Christ, right?
And the head of the woman is the man.
The head of the woman is the man, right?
And the head of Christ is God.
And the head of Christ is God. So it's a structure with God. It's right. God, Christ, man, woman, and children, right? Read.
Every man praying or prophesying, having his head covered, dishonoreth his head.
So it said every man praying or prophesying, having his head covered, dishonoreth his head. So with the scriptures coming out, and we talking about Christ, and if you got your head covered, who are you dishonoring?
God. So I got my hat on, so I just, the scriptures coming out, so I got my hat on, mm-hmm. so I got you.
Right, that's right, my nerve. Right. Exactly. You, meaning, you don't want to dishonor God. You want to listen to what God, what Christ say. You know what I'm saying? So our praise is showing signs of repentance, you know, because guess what? The laws and so forth was all given to us. Give me that holy convocation, Leviticus 23. So now, Diedrich, it's time for you to start keeping, having holy convocation with your brothers. You know what I'm saying? On the Sabbath day. You know, carpool, man. You need, we carpool up there. If you ain't got a ride.
Man,
you know what I'm
saying? Brand, oh, I do commercial roofing. I just got it off.
Oh, okay.
And I seen you. I had to turn around. I throw my head on his head. I was like, yeah.
All praise to Diedrich. But you know part of the Sabbath.
I know you're supposed to work on Sabbath.
Right.
But
you know what I'm saying?
I can feed my family. Or I can be out here. You know, I know too.
And so forth. Watch it. You know what I'm saying? And so forth. So if you can eventually find somewhere where, you know, you are at your boss, you know, hey, can I request these days off or so forth?
I can request these days off, but it rained all this week. You know what I'm saying? I do commercial roofing.
Oh, okay.
You know what I'm saying? I represent back roofing. I understand. Right. I had to go,
you know what I'm saying? So when you got the Sabbath off, guess where you should be at?
With y'all.
With us congregating, right. Keeping God's laws, Diedrich.
Right.
That's where you should be. Because guess what?
And I try to remember, guess what? I swear I had to get off that roof, man.
Huh?
I had to stop. Yeah, man. And to get in contact with y'all. Because, no, I'm down with
the
Sabbath.
But we want to see you at the school, Diedrich. Man, you know what I'm saying? Hey, don't not say it. You know,
no,
you're going to be
no,
there
and
not show up.
I check my phone. That's all I listen to. I just try to learn as much as I can. I see y'all out here.
Guess what? Give me Psalm 94:16. Give me Psalm 94:16. I'm going to show you something else. I'm going to show you something else before you go. Watch this. Psalm 94:16. Because guess what? God's calling you, brother. God is calling you. Watch this.
This is the book of Psalms, chapter 94. And verse 16, who will rise up for me against the evildoers?
God is asking you a question. Who will rise up for him against the evildoers? So guess what? Our people that love to sin, love to do evil, God saying, who's going to rise up for him? Guess what? We all had the choice to say who's going to rise up for God. Are we going to be the man for the job and do what he says?
Yeah.
We all had to, you know, take terms with that. Read.
Or who will stand up for me against the workers of iniquity?
Who gonna stand up for God against the workers of iniquity? Who gonna stand up for him telling people to stop sin? Stop keeping Christmas, these wicked high holy days, to keep God's commandments, to keep the Sabbath, tell the sisters to stop wearing pants and getting a dress, tell our brothers to stop pouring out our sisters and marrying them, telling our brothers to stop shooting each other and selling drugs to each other,
right,
and come and love one another, like the scripture says. Read.
How you doing, sir?
Unless the Lord had been my help, my soul had almost dwelt in silence.
How you doing, sis? What's your name?
Lanita.
Lanita, I'm Jacob. Nice to meet you, Lanita. So what we out here doing, like we teaching Diedrich here, Lanita, we teaching him that he actually knows we are the people, the Israelites. Do you know that? You know that? Yeah, we are God's chosen people, the greatest people ever. So like I read for Diedrich, Lanita, right? I'm going to read something for you, but I'm going to ask you. How do you prove you love God?
I buried my son.
Oh, you buried your son? Today?
8 months ago.
8 months ago? Oh, what happened to your son?
Doesn't matter.
Oh, okay.
He's not here no more.
Okay, but we gonna read the scripture. You said you love God, right?
Yeah, I love
God. Okay. Read. Huh? Watch this.
This is the book of 1 John, chapter 5 and verse 3. For this is the love of God, that we keep his commandments.
So what's the love of God, Lanita?
To keep his peace.
To keep his commandments.
For this is the love of God, that we keep his commandments.
So if you love God, you're going to keep his commandments, right? So now, Lolita, give me Deuteronomy 22:5 and give me Malachi, keep the law of Malachi 2:7.
Okay, watch this. So now, love God, you gotta keep the commandment. Now, Lolita, we messengers of God. We bring the word. That's what we do. We bring God's word. And we gonna bring it to our people. Watch this. We need you.
This is the book of Deuteronomy. Chapter 22:5.
Read out.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
It said the woman should wear which pertaineth unto a man. That's actually a commandment. Read that. Read on.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
So, Lenita, what shouldn't a man put on that's a woman's garment?
Panties.
Okay. What else? Huh? Wait, what else? Like clothing. What's a woman's skirt? Okay, skirt, dress, you would say. So a man shouldn't wear those things, right? Right?
Because they wear that shit and cover shit on up. Wear that shit.
Because guess what? If a man putting on a dress and a skirt, that puts a what spirit on him? A feminine spirit on him, right? Like a girly spirit on him, right? Right? You agree?
Okay.
Read on.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment, for all that do so are abomination unto the Lord thy God.
God said that's an abomination. God said he hates all abomination. Now, go back to the top. Now, let's get this one.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
So now, the scripture said a woman shouldn't wear which pertains unto a man. So what shouldn't a woman wear that pertains to a man, Leninda?
Daisy Dukes, booty shorts, all up there, see his ass, he can't breathe and shit.
What do you have on?
I got jeans and a t-shirt on.
Is that women's or man clothing?
It's woman clothing, I'm
no.
A woman.
No. Pants are not women's clothing, sis.
No,
because you just said earlier a dress and a skirt were women clothing, did you not?
This is 2021.
No, give me that Exodus. Pants were always made for men. Now, what your slave master did was make you think there's such things as women pants.
Right.
There is no such thing.
Nah.
That man is the deceiver, and he deceived you, he lied to you, and make you think there's such thing as women's pants. There we go. When the truth come out, they start running. That will happen. You don't love God. You just said you love God to keep his commandments. But when the commandments come out, you don't want to hear the truth and you start running. You love your oppressor. That's what it is. Our people love their oppressor. You love your oppressor. We brought out the truth. You said dress in a skirt off a woman, and if a man in a dress or a skirt, he's feminine. But when we said a pants is for men, you're going to say that's woman clothing. That is foolish as hell. God said our people are foolish. Read.
This is the book of Exodus, chapter 28 and verse 41.
Read out.
And thou shalt put them upon Aaron thy brother and his sons with him, and shall anoint them, and consecrate them, and sanctify them, that they may minister unto me in the priest's office.
Uh-huh.
And thou shalt make them linen breeches to cover their nakedness, from the loins even unto the thighs they shall reach.
Hear that? Linen breeches. Breech, another word for breech is pants. Pants are for men. They were for Aaron and who?
For Aaron and his sons.
Aaron and his sons, not Aaron and his daughters. Aaron and who?
Aaron thy brother and his sons with him. And thou shalt anoint them, and consecrate them, and sanctify them, that they may minister unto me in the priest's office.
So pants was for men, not women. Pants were never for women. Dresses and skirts, that's women's clothing. That is, pants are not women's clothing. But you guess what? Our people love to listen to their oppressor, and they believe anything their oppressor say. If the oppressor say, there's such thing as woman pants, guess what the women say? Oh, I guess that's right. There gotta be such thing as woman pants. But when the laws come out that you're not supposed to be in pants, you have a problem with it. Our people have a problem with when we just the messengers of God giving you the truth, thus saith the Lord. Give me Isaiah 30 and 8. Give me Isaiah 30 and 8. Because the sister don't want to walk into the truth. She want to believe she can continue walking around in pants and so forth. Guess what? You continue to walk around in pants when Christ comes back, it is up with your head. Christ is going to have no mercy. Christ is tired of playing with you stiff-necked people. You stiff-necked sisters that want to think you can be in pants and think it's okay.
Right.
Guess what? When Christ comes back, if you're in pants, it's up with your head.
Right.
Read.
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 30 and verse 8.
Read out.
Now, go write it before them in a table, and note it in a book, that it may be for the time to come, forever and ever.
So God said, go and write it and note it in a book for these people. They are what?
That this is a rebellious people.
Rebellious. The sister Lynette that was up here, guess what? Rebellious. Two-thirds of our people is going to continue to rebel against God. You brought out the script, you should not wear pants.
Right.
She has a problem with that. It's woman pants. No, it's not. You being rebellious and stiff-necked.
Right.
Read.
That this is a rebellious people. Lying children.
Lying children. She just sat up here and lied, didn't she? Lie, lie, lie. Said skirts and dresses, if a man in them, it is feminine, but it's okay for a woman to be in pants. That is cross-dressing.
Read out.
Stop lying to yourself. Read.
Lying children. Children that will not hear the law of the Lord.
And that sister didn't want to hear the laws of the Lord. She didn't want to hear the laws. Because guess what? She wanted to hear the laws. She would have humbled down and listened to the laws as they come out. But guess what? A lot of our people don't want to hear the laws of the Lord. You know what they want to hear? They want to hear Creflo Dollar.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.